We're doing a television series.
Peter for 8 years. She joined the programme on the same day as her master, new presenter Simon Groom.
Goldie was just 7 weeks old when she first appeared on the programme in May 1978.
A gorgeous puppy.
How about that then?
How's she doing? Is she
alright? Fantastic, considering she's never been anywhere near a TV studio before. Marvellous.
She'd come from a litter of seven and didn't even have a name yet. Viewers chose the name Goldie, which she quickly learned. Goldie lived with Simon in London and they soon started the important job of puppy walking, introducing her to unusual sights, smells and sounds.
Have a look at that then. What do you think of that? Who's a pretty girl?
When Simon went filming abroad that year, Goldie went to Devon for training with dog expert Richard Duckworth. On Simon's return, both dog and master were put through their paces.
Goldie, sit.
Good girl. Good girl.
Just remember, Simon, there will be times when she doesn't get down when you give her the command. If she doesn't, enforce your command.
Come on,
Goldie, sit.
Come into her as quickly as you can and put pressure with your hand onto her. Down!
Very good indeed.
During her long life, Goldie never forgot what she learned as a puppy.
From the Blue Peter programme.
It was a proud moment for Blue Peter when Goldie was invited to join the personality parade at Crufts in 1979.
I'm also very grateful, Mr. Groom, for the work that your team does in the promotion of the welfare of the dog. And it is indeed a great delight to us all to be able to welcome you both to Crufts.
Goldie, come on.
Simon often took Goldie to his parents' farm in Derbyshire, where she spent many happy times in the country. Wherever Simon went in Britain, Goldie went too. To him, she was simply the best dog in the world.
First of all, though, just have a look at all Goldie's cards.
Goldie was loved by thousands of viewers, and each year on her birthday, the studio was swamped with homemade cards and presents. On her third birthday, she gave birth to her first litter of pups, and 7 years later, in 1986, her second litter followed. Eight puppies were born on a snowy February evening. The sheer number took everyone by surprise.
Now, Goldie, I'm sure you're ready for this. They must be thirsty. Nothing but the best at Diana's, eh? Chicken soup.
A few weeks later, they were all in the studio with Derek Freeman, puppy walking manager for the Guide Dogs for the Blind Association, who gave them his famous test.
And clap your hands again, you know, and then perhaps even backfire another calf.
Once again, viewers sent in names by the thousand for the puppies, and one was chosen for a now famous Blue Peter pet.
Well, that just leaves the little bitch that we're keeping for the programme, and a very popular suggestion, a name we all like too, is Bonnie. Here she is. I expect she'll get used to her name very soon.
A few months later, this get-together in the Blue Peter garden was a grand reunion for the puppies and Goldie. The object was to take a picture for the Radio Times, but the pups had other ideas. After some gentle persuasion, the dogs posed like budding film stars, and the picture was perfect.
Pretty, match the core. Have a chew on that.
In the summer of 1986, Goldie and Simon both left Blue Peter. Like Simon, Goldie had 8 great years on the programme with many memorable moments. She truly was a dog loved by millions.
Oh, she had a good life, didn't she?
She did.
Well, if you've got a pet, I hope you have as much love from her as Simon had from Goldie. Although I never met her myself, I know from talking to members of the team who knew Goldie very well how much she was loved. She was 14 and a half, which is a good old age for a golden retriever, and she'd become quite ill. So the vet and Simon thought it was much kinder to put her to sleep than to let her suffer.